In this tutorial, I'll show you how to prepare and render this photorealistic image in 6 minutes. The purpose of creating a scene like this is to set up and save our own photorealistic render scene, so that they can be used for our future photorealism projects. This method will save a great amount of time, and I would highly recommend everyone to set up and keep an indoor, an outdoor, a Lightroom production shot, and so on. Always have a pre-built render scene save file ready, and use them to avoid setting up everything again and again each time we create a new project in the future. Blender allows users to save unique render settings and other details per save file, so please use them to save time in the future. In the previous tutorial, I have mentioned how I have copied and pasted meshes from other Blender save files. Open a new document and open another Blender save file that contains the mesh we need. If the meshes are separated, select and Ctrl+J to join them. Ctrl+C to copy, and go to the original Blender we opened in the beginning. Ctrl+V to paste. S to scale. Let's copy and paste a table mesh the same way. G and Z to move on the Z axis. S to scale. Let's create a plane. I'll use a set of PBR images as its material. R, X, and 90 to rotate the mesh 90 degrees on the X axis. Let's find the best angle to render and set up the render scene. Select the main node, and press Ctrl, Shift, and T, together to add the PBR texture images. To use the Ctrl, Shift, T feature, we need to activate an add-on called the Node Wrangler. I'll use the sky texture. Let's move the plane closer to the table. I'll move the plant closer to the wall. Please remember to scale the PBR images any way you like. I'll use 128 samples to render. Here are my usual render settings. I'll show you how to spot common mistakes and correct them. I have prepared this shot for my initial practice run. Here are some of the issues. The background plaster and the ground floor marble textures are too big. Also, the plant seems a bit too big as well. I have scaled the textures in the node editor to fix the scale issues like this. This looked good, and I have tried another camera angle and that looked better. I have saved this blend file, and I will use it if I need to render an outdoor photorealistic scene in the future. All I need to do is removing and replacing the meshes that were imported or just create one myself. And that's how we set up a scene and make it ready for the future. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.